Hi, welcome back. Remember, this is our second lesson on geometrical exercises by paper folding. So this is what we are doing next. Okay, remember last class, we started with what is meant by a line and a point and an angle. I hope you still have the sheet. If not, remake this sheet. Okay, so what I want is fold once, open it, fold again. Okay, so that you get an intersection, mark the intersection, mark the lines, mark the base and slant like this. Okay, so if you haven't done that, pause the video right here, make this shape. If you already have this shape, what I want you to do is cut out 4 pieces from this shape. Okay, what I want you to do is to cut the 4 wedges out from this shape. What I mean, let me cut and show you. So wedge number 1. So go along these things and cut out wedge number 1. You might typically get 4 pieces like this. The first time I am showing you what I mean when I say cut out something. Afterwards, I will just show you the cut piece so that you are ready for it. So right now this is a cutting exercise. So cut out these 4 pieces. Okay, so now you should have 4 wedges. Okay. So please remember, I have 4 wedges. So now we are going to talk about what is meant by congruence. Which means, actually, literally, it means same if they put on top. So when are two shapes same? So I got this wedge and I got this wedge. Can you see these 2 wedges? The question is that they clearly look different, right? I mean, first of all, the overall shape of the piece is different. That's not what I'm talking about. I'm only talking about the wedge. So forget about these 2 lines. So imagine only these 2 lines. So this line goes like that. Okay. And this one is much narrower. Can you see that? This wedge is much narrower than this one. Forget about this portion. So remember all of these things, the lines extend forever. The lines extend forever. Okay. The question is, are these 2 things the same? What do we mean by that? The answer is there some way I can put one on top of the other so that they can become the same? Well, what can I do to one of the wedges? So I can take this wedge, I can move it around like this. Can you see that? Without changing its orientation. Moving something around without changing their orientation is called translation. Translate means to move something without changing its orientation. Can you see? It's always, the mouth is always pointing the same direction. The tip is always pointing the same direction. So that's what we mean by translation, right? So let's do that word first. Translation. Moving a piece of paper without changing orientation. The second one that we are going to talk about is called rotation. That means changing orientation. What I mean by that is rotation means I take an object like this and I change its orientation. Can you see that mouth is pointing in different ways? This is rotation. Okay. Translation means mouth is always pointing in the same way. Okay. So these are two basic motions, and it should be intuitive to you that intuitively they will not so neither of these things, neither translation nor rotation, will actually change the shape of the wedge. You can see that how wide the wedge is and what its mouth looks like and all of that. These will not change the shape. Okay, so I can translate it, I can rotate it, it will not change the shape. Now we talk about what do we mean by congruence. Oh, by the way, there's one more item which is called flipping. This is called reflection. What do I mean by reflection? I'm going to take this and flip it over like that. Now, if I look at the wedge, if I have to mark it, this will become the base. This will become the slant. And here is the direction. Can you see that it is the opposite way? Can you see the two arrows? Can you see the two arrows? Can you see how they are opposite to each other? So when I flip it, the mouth still says the same, but what used to be base becomes edge, what used to be slant, what used to be slant becomes base, and what if it is going from base to slant, it will go the opposite way. Can you see that? This kind of a thing is called flipping or reflection, changing the sense. So for example, this is what happens to you in a mirror. So if you hold this in your mirror, the same kind of thing will happen. If you hold this up to a mirror, same kind of thing will happen. That's what happens when you look at yourself in the mirror. It's you, it's the same shape, but left is right, right is left. Your left hand looks like your right hand looks like your left hand, right? So that's what we mean by flipping or reflection. So we are going to say change orientation, move things around, and flipping. So these are the three actions. So these three actions do not change the shape. They are more or less the same, right? They, you know, whatever was the wedge, but I could do other things. I could crumple something and make something. All the other actions So now we come to the idea that two wedges are congruent if we can translate, rotate one of the wedges to lie on top of the other. So your task is, we cut out four wedges. You remember these four wedges? So your task is to figure out whether there is any congruence between them or not. So I'm going to pick this wedge and this wedge, and you can see that if I align them, what do I mean by align them? Mouth has to be the same direction as the mouth, and tip has to be the same direction as the slip. Bases have to line up, slants have to line up, everything has to line up. Notice that if I try to make it so that mouth and mouth, tip and tip are fine, base and base are fine, but the slants are not. So these two are not congruent. Now, how about these two? Okay, so now notice that I could make it so that tip and tip are same. Okay, base and base are same. Now you can see that slant and slant are also same. So these two edges are congruent. Remember that these things don't matter. They extend forever. So it's really all of this region. Okay, only three things that matter are base, slant, and tip. These things have to align, and then you have whether something is congruent or not. So find me. So go look at it and check whether something else is congruent or not. By the way, you can extend it further by saying I can also add flip. So I can say if I can translate, rotate, or flip something to make them align, then they are congruent. But this is an extension. Of course, you know, it is very clear that these two things are not congruent, right? But what if I folded it up like this? So until let's do this correct. So I'm going to fold it like so, whatever I need until I make them exactly congruent. So why can't I fold it up until I make it congruent, right? But the problem is folding is not an allowed operation. You cannot fold something to make the two items congruent because folding is not allowed. So if I fold it, technically I can make these two things same. But folding is not an operation that preserves shape, right? I'm not allowed to fold something or crumple it in some way. So those kinds of operations are not allowed. Only operations allowed are translations, rotations, flipping. That makes sense to you? So that is our second lesson. So the idea is, what is translation? What is rotation? What is flipping? And how to make things congruent? Thank you very much.